We know that when a system absorbs thermal energy, its temperature increases. We can calculate heat absorbed using the equation heat equals mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature. Specific heat capacity is the energy required to increase the temperature of 1 gram of a substance by 1 degree Celsius. Different materials have different specific heat capacities. For example, water has a relatively high specific heat capacity of 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius. Sand, on the other hand, has a much lower specific heat capacity, around 0.84 joules per gram degree Celsius. This is why water has a moderating effect on temperature and weather. If you picture a desert, the temperature during the day may be extremely hot, but at night it can get very cold. The very large temperature difference comes from the lack of water. If we compare this to a small island, the island's temperature from day to night is moderated by the surrounding water, so there is a much smaller change. Let's practice. Our problem reads, to determine if a shiny gold-colored substance is actually gold, a chemistry student decides to measure its specific heat capacity. The mass of the sample is 4.7 grams. Upon absorbing 57.2 joules of heat, the temperature of the substance rises from 25 degrees Celsius to 57 degrees Celsius. Find the specific heat capacity of the sample. Is it consistent with gold? We'll start with our equation, heat equals mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature. We want to solve for specific heat capacity. Rearranging our equation, we get specific heat capacity equals heat divided by mass times change in temperature. We can plug our values in from the problem, calculating the change in temperature as the final temperature minus the initial temperature. Completing this calculation, we get 0.38 joules per gram degree Celsius. So this substance is not consistent with gold.